My name is Linnéa and I'm a FacePaint.com blogger. My very first face painting was in 2016. I was at the family holiday on Tenerife and I watched the hotel staff doing face painting on the kids there. And I thought that it would be a very great idea to do at work at home, because I worked in a toy shop and we often did events on kids. And when I got home, I told my boss. He was very thrilled about it, and I bought myself a starting kit and started practicing at home. And 4 months later, I got the first gig at the store, and it was a success. And the kids loved it, and they wanted me to go to their birthday parties and stuff like that. So I started up my own company, and now, about 3 years later, the company has been growing and I can offer a lot more than just face painting on kids. And I also invest in myself. I have recently graduated from Olga Morasev's International Face Painting School. I'm Sweden's first and so far only one. Yay! And I also did a lot of workshops as well. So I really invest in myself because I have finally found the thing I'm really passionate about and really love to do, and it is this industry. Anyway, today I got 4 business tips for you guys that aren't face painting, but the first one is always hand out your business card. Here is my business card. I always hand it out at the events or at birthday parties, but I also give them a second card. I give to each parent both of the cards. The second card is a washing advice card. I have wrote down how to most effectively but also most gently remove the face painting from the child, and it's really appreciated. And you know, I have a couple of friends that was being face painting in another city far away from here, and they told me that they were standing in line for face painting for 40 minutes, and just when it was their turn, the line was closed. I could never do that too, because I don't want to upset the kids or the parents. So when I have about 1 hour left or something like that, I count how many kids they are, and I put this one on the last one. It says in Swedish, of course, but it says, "Sorry, I'm the last one in line for face painting." And I just put on this over the kids like that and tell them, "Congratulations, you're the last one for face painting today." And I can assure you, they are really, really showing it off. So it's a very easy way to do that. And you know, when you have the third tip is when, you know, when you are about to pack everything down and go home for today, they are always coming, kids and parents, at the last minute. "Oh, don't you have time for one face painting more or two?" or something like that. But I also tell them that, "Sorry, the face painting is closed. I have packed my brushes and colors already. But you know what? I have these cute magic books. I have decorated myself. Anyway, you can open it up and you can choose 2 temporary tattoos to bring home. I bought them very cheap. They are, you know, with Frozen and princesses and cars and Spider-Man and stuff like that. And it isn't face painting, but the kids are very, very happy that they get something rather than nothing. And it's that small details that makes the parents think that you are a real professional. And the fourth tip I got for you is, make every and each kid feel special. Put the interesting what they like. I'm always, you know, reading and watching movies and stuff like that to know what the kids like. So I can discuss with them the latest My Little Pony movie or Star Wars series or which superhero got the coolest power and stuff like that. So just make that little time to know what the kids like, so you can discuss it with them, and I can assure you that they will think you are awesome. So that was all for today. Please look at my work here on FacePaint.com and follow me on social medias. Have a great day! Happy painting! Bye!